Welcome back to Cradle. I need to head back to the Gerbera Gardens to Pavilion Number 2 to try to find another part for Ida. So let's go ahead and head back there. I do want to start reading some of these notes in this episode, hopefully, but I'm going to save that for the end of the episode, I think. I want to see how long the Gerbera Gardens thing takes. Hold on a second. I want to try something. I want to see if I can put the battery in here now, or if I still have to wait for something. Yeah, it looks like I still can't. Dang. I really want to do that. Oh yeah, the song again. Now we get to hear the rest of it. You know what? I probably should have went to that thing. You know what? I'm gonna go back just to ride it. Just for funsies. It's probably gonna take about the same amount of time. Pretty. Also probably very dangerous to stand underneath that, but still pretty. What? No, take me. Going to go? I don't get how this thing works. I mashed those buttons and nothing happened. Yeah, you can actually stop it anywhere you want. Or is this just where it naturally stops? I think these are the instructions, actually. The length of braking distance is calculated automatically. Contact tech support in the event of equipment breakdown. Yeah, so you can just stop it whenever you want and then just keep on going. Oh, does this actually go inside? No, it just stops here.
You wanted to know about the look screen. When you undergo a transfer, you put your palm over the palm of your future body and look into its eyes. It's like looking into a mirror. But this part is crucial. The transfer can't happen without it. Then you're immersed into a kind of peculiar state when you see yourself from the side. On a signal, you push off with your palm and a mirror appears between you. And then you're alone again, in your new body.
That's so strange. So very, very strange. Okay, Pavilion Number 2. That would be you. Oh, God. I didn't quite throw the stick at it fast enough. It's alright. I'm okay. By the way, I've noticed that if you kind of like sprint and jump at the top of these, you can get some serious height. Whee!
I see you. Opening.
Okay, time to pass out and play another minigame, I guess. Alright, gas me. Alright, what daft minigame will we have this time? It's probably not going to be any better than the last one. I just hope it's different, to at least give me some variety. Yep, it's definitely different. Thirty pink cubes. Hurl cubes into the uprising stream. Use bombs to destroy gray blocks. Pink to red equals explosion. Okay, so it's actually very similar to the last one, but a little bit different. So the difference is, I can't just do that. No, you can't. Wait, what? Oh. That's what I have to destroy. Yeah, I kinda really need to destroy that. Okay. So I need to... Wow. This is gonna be annoying, so I gotta move the red one into place. Oh, great, thanks. Thank you so much. No! Shit. My cubes! Don't you dare explode! I didn't even do anything. Ah, whatever, you can do it there. Alright, I'm just gonna collect these as madly and fastly as possible. Yes, please explode there. That's fine. I don't care. Oh, fuck off. Come on, stop sucking. Oh, go away. Yes, yes, please explode there. That is very convenient, actually. And that was not sarcasm. That was actually a convenient place to explode. Oh. Another one? Really? Just explode right there. Oh. Oh, if you're in the where the explosion is, the bricks can't form. Interesting. Could be useful. Maybe I should just, like, tank the explosion or something. Alright, I gotta Minecraft my way up. Well, I could always go into the stream, I guess. Well, actually, no, I can't. It's blocked off. You know, can I just fall down? No, I can't. I'm on the lower level. My points! Don't explode my... Thank you. I'm almost there. Almost there. Three more. And we got it. No, it's sucking him in. All right, let's do this again. There. Now we got it. I don't even care if you explode. Doesn't matter. I win. That was another waste of time. Yeah, these minigames are terrible. Whoa. Am I crazy or does it look grayer and deader than it did before? Oh, it's foggy, isn't it? Yeah, a fog set in.
I told you about the mirror between you and your former body. So, the mirror is turned on at the exact moment when your former body loses its original's right. It is concealed to keep you from seeing your face as it's put to death. The reason is that sometimes there are involuntary, mimicking contractions that resemble a smile. Obviously, that is something best left unseen.
The whole transfer process is very, very unsettling. Yeah, so it looks like you pressed the middle button. Whoops. It looks like you pressed the middle button, even though it's already lit up. You press it, and you make it unlit up to go in the air, which is weird. That's kind of the inverse of what I thought. You would need to do. I thought you'd need to light the button up to be in the air, but apparently not. So you press the middle button, makes you go up in the air, and then you press the direction. Looks like Tabaha is back. Or Tabaha. Tabaha Blast Spicy Nachos. Hey, he did get a hat. He took my suggestion.
Have you got a death wish? Why would you go there?
Where?
Oh, nowhere. Did you bring the flowers?
Here you go.
Attaboy. Here is your lens. My word is my bond. I'm not even going to ask what you want with it. I don't know what's going on in your head today. And I don't want to know.
Tabaha, what do you know about this amusement park?
Stay away from it, if you know what's good for you. Why do you think it's been fenced off? Because you shouldn't go in there. You'll be better off.
You must remember something. Tell me.
Think, man. I wasn't even around back then. There was an amusement park. And I guess someone must have exploded in there. Am I supposed to remember every explosion that ever happened? All I know is this damn poison-filled behemoth has been standing there for 20 years now, and nobody ever gave a crap, but suddenly you do. Why?
I'm curious. It's just so strange.
Sure it is. But why do you care? What are you after?
I want to know why kids were undergoing transfers.
If they were, then there was a reason for it. Why does that even surprise you? It's just a regular mirror transfer.
But to Baja, they don't do transfers to kids.
To ordinary kids, they don't. These kids, they may not have been all that ordinary. I saw them once at an airport, with their teachers. I remember those kids standing there all pale and silent. It was forbidden to talk to them. So there.
Forbidden to talk to them? Were these... Were these maybe very, very sick kids? So they're pale. Pale and silent. Were they perhaps extremely ill? And so the transfer was to try to give them a chance at life? Because their old bodies were dying?
At an airport? Where were they coming from?
From all over. They were being brought here from all corners of the world.
What's so special about these parts?
Damned if I know. There used to be some kind of station here. A polar station.
A polar station?
They were researching something.
So there actually used to be a polar station here. I mean, it doesn't seem cold enough for this to be polar. But okay, yeah, apparently there was a polar research station here. That explains the sign. Remember the sign just outside the fence of Gerbera Gardens? The one that said something, something polar research station, and then it showed pictures of, like, all the research staff there?
Polar?
I think that's what they called it. It didn't interest me in the slightest.
To Baja, I've got a request for you.
Let me guess. You want me to dig up everything there is to know about the Gerbera Garden, am I right?
Only what happened on the day of the explosion.
Jeez, Anabish. Won't you just forget about this damn garden? Fine, I'll look into it.
Thanks, Tabaha.
All right, I've got a roll. Last thing I need is to rack up airs and lose my wits. You know how vulnerable I am to that stuff. I may look calm and collected, but I've got crazy energy and passion for life.
You look just plain odd. Those glasses and nose.
These glasses are one of a kind. You couldn't get them in your wildest dreams. But I got them at half price. That's because I'm a high roller, while you'll be chasing such luxuries all your life.
I wouldn't call those glasses a luxury. Or that nose. That nose looks like it came, like, straight from one of those comedy faces. You know, those little stupid faces you buy with, like, a fake nose and mustache? In fact, I think that's what it is, because there's even a little mustache there.
Please, don't forget about my request.
Goodbye! Take this with you! Actually, no, please don't. Actually, could I have actually thrown that? Oh my god, can you actually throw that on board? Can you throw that on board and then it just, like, goes away with him and you never get it? I actually want to know if that's possible. Like, I seriously want to know if that's possible. Where's the last save? Ah, it's here. Well, actually, it's right here. I'm gonna load this game and I'm gonna see where it is exactly. Hopefully it's just when he starts to lift off and it's still in my hands. No, it's all the way back here. Alright, so I'm gonna go do that again and I'm gonna test it. I'll be right back. Okay, here we go. Let's try this. I'm going to try to throw it, like, right in behind his seat, or maybe above him.
Thanks,
here we go.
Baja.
All right.
You look just plain odd. Those glasses and nose.
Come on.
These glasses.
Please, don't
forget. Okay, here we go. Here we go.
Quest.
And... No. No! Son of a... I don't know where it went for the first throw. It didn't go in even though I was aiming way up. I think there might be an invisible wall or something. Ah, balls. I wanted to soft lock the game. Ooh, Ungots is back. Came back for more food. Hey, buddy. Keeping warm in there? Ida is going to be very, very happy.
Did you bring what I asked?
I did.
The look screen as well?
The look screen and the lens. Let's connect them.
Disconnect the broken look screen. The input is inside, right behind it. Install the lens first, and then my eyes.
And then your eyes.
So I'm going to take her face off, basically. What? I feel like this is going to look scary. Okay. Yeah, that's creepy. Yeah, that's really creepy. Ew. Oh my god, that is terrifying. Holy crap, put the face on. Alright, there we go. Can you see me? Can she see now? I think she can see. Yeah, she can see. Oh, sorry. I was trying to talk to her, not take off her chest.
Well? How's your vision? Is it working?
Yes. I just...
Okay, so she can see. She's probably disturbed by what she is, where she is, and the fact that she can't move. At least can't move her lower body.
What?
Nothing. It's fine. My eyesight is back, thank you.
What happened? Did you remember something?
Yes, actually, I did. I know now why I wasn't on that list.
Why weren't you?
I wasn't on staff. I would come to the Gerbera Garden with the kids and go back with the same group, meaning I wasn't a full-time employee. I merely accompanied the children.
Tabaha said those kids were accompanied by teachers.
Those weren't teachers. It was psychologists that accompanied them. I'm a children's psychologist.
Why the need for a psychologist at an amusement park?
Enebish, this is not an amusement park at all. Those kids didn't come here for entertainment. They were gravely ill and were brought here for treatment. The Gerbera Garden was a clinic.
Okay, yeah. So they were pale and they're forbidden... you're forbidden from talking to the kids. I thought that meant that they maybe were ill, and that they're being transferred to a different body as a type of treatment, and it looks like that is the case. It was a clinic. But then, why the games, though? I mean, if it's a clinic, why these games? Why playing these... Why do the kids have to go to a strange chamber and get knocked out? And then play games to get parts for their new body. I don't get that part.
What were they treated for?
Some kind of psychological disorder. Quite severe, often fatal. But it's hard to say exactly what it was. I can't recall.
You mean the transfer was their therapy?
One part of it, yes. There was a whole set of measures. Body replacement was the final phase of the therapy. We also searched for parts and staged plays. They too were part of the treatment.
How were they part of the treatment?
Plays? What kind of plays?
I remember this one episode. There was a vessel in front of the stage, kind of like a bathtub.
It's still there. I saw it.
Well, the kids would put embody parts in it. Each one would bring their own part from the pavilion and put it into the bathtub. And as it filled up, the MC would combine all the parts into a single body.
And what happened then?
And then there was a cloud of steam. The body would be quickly, imperceptibly replaced with a young woman's, and she would pick up the lead. She would fight some giant head. And then something else would happen. I can't remember all the details.
Okay, well, I saw the giant head. That's the thing that, like, spews out black, like a cloud of black stuff.
And the cubes? Were they also part of the treatment?
The cubes, the flower beds, even the height of the pavilions. All were deliberate, mandatory elements of the same therapy. The Gerbera Garden was constructed specifically for those children. It was the only means of treating their illness, peculiar though it may have been.
The illness must have been peculiar to Madge.
It's still hard for me to imagine what it might have been, but those kids, they evoked more than just compassion. There was something else, some other complicated, ambiguous feeling.
Tabaha is right. Those kids were unusual.
Yes, and the amusement park was as well. Which means all arrivals had to be registered, myself included. I'll try to look for some kind of visitor's logbook or...
Or what? What is it?
My battery. It's nearly discharged.
Bad news. I need you to make sense of all this.
In that case, Enibis, you'll need to play with those cubes some more.
Sure thing, Ida. I'll play. Which pavilion?
A moment. Hands, wrists. There, the fuel cell. 10th pavilion.
Oh god, so it looks like I have to play another minigame. No, please no. Also, I've been pronouncing her name Ida. Apparently it's Ida. Sorry. Ida, Ida. Potato, potato.
Help me understand something.
What?
You mentioned original's right. What is that?
That's a right to bear identity. When a new M-body is activated during a transfer, it is also bestowed original's right, thus acquiring an identity. At that very moment, the former body loses this right and is destroyed.
Destroyed? Why?
I'm not sure. Perhaps to ensure the two never communicate.
Why? What would happen if they communicate?
I can't be sure. That's a rare occurrence. I believe the consequences are rather strange. I don't know how to explain it.
I feel like that might be something that has happened to me or to her.
Got it.
Well, I want to read these notes, because now is kind of like the perfect time to do it, but that beeping noise that's coming from her, indicating low battery, is going to be in my ear, interrupting me constantly, and it's going to drive me crazy. So let's save that for another time. Let's see if I can get the fuel cell real quick. Okay, did she say 10th? Yeah. This music is so good. Search the 10th pavilion. She's not gonna open the door? Is it related to this strange bubble that I looked at before but couldn't do anything with? I want to grab that cube. Aw, I can't. Oh, what the heck is this? I will vanquish my foes. What am I supposed to vanquish with this?
The illness in those kids wasn't accidental. Before getting sick, there was something special about them, some kind of useful quality. This quality allegedly gave them an intellectual advantage over grown-ups.
It sounds like maybe these kids were...
I see you. Go on in.
It sounds like maybe these kids were thought to be perhaps, maybe they would hold the key to saving the human race, to curing the illness, or something like that. Man, this thing sends off a lot of sparks. Wow. Am I supposed to take it in with me? I don't know. I'm gonna take it in with me. Yeah. Light show. Take that wall. Alright, what daft minigame do we have now? Let me guess. Hurl blue cubes, or green cubes, or some other type of cube color. Yellow cubes! Apply yellow cube to a white one to create a platform. So this is exactly the same as the first game, except with different colors. Okay. Oh, crap. This music. And try to be as fast as possible. Damn it. Oh, this is getting really precarious. I got a lot of platforms here, too. Oh god. Crap. These were hiding. Alright, just one more. And we got it. Wait, my sword. Hey. Hey! Where's my sword?
I found out what special quality those kids had. They had exceptionally developed visual perception. Visual and aesthetic. For them, the shape, color, and the like of surrounding objects was of critical importance. Some things were beautiful in their eyes, others the definition of ugly. And here's the kicker. They were always in consensus. But it was that very ability that ultimately became their blight. The particulars, however, I still do not know.
So they're exceptionally good at judging beauty, I guess. And so the aesthetics of this place were particularly chosen for them to be beautiful, I think. Colors and shapes, so that must be why there's cubes everywhere and why they're different colors and things like that. I'm gonna take this with me. And I want to find some black goo to see if I can vanquish it with this this fantasy sword. I can't put it in my... Oh, that's weird. I thought I couldn't put it in my inventory, but it looks like I can. Oh, that's right. I forgot. You can't put stuff in your inventory when Ida's talking. Yeah, any goo to stab? Oh, there's some. Come here. Oh, there's some that's even closer. Ha ha! Popped ya. I wonder if this sword has any actual practical purposes other than that. Also, didn't I hear Tabaha? When I heard Tabaha. Did I not? I guess not.
Did you bring the battery?
Here it is. Let's replace it.
Go ahead. But you'll need to switch me off first.
All right.
Here come the shakes again.
Well, no way around that.
Yep. Shut me down.
See you in a minute.
Yeah, being forcefully put to sleep basically can't be pleasant. Battery probably goes in her chest. Whoops, no, no, don't stab her with the fantasy sword. That's not what I meant to select. Oh my god, I'm so sorry. No, I guess it goes in her brain. No?
Where does it go?
Is it in your back? Maybe it does go in the chest and just need to put it in a different spot. I need to free a slot. Oh, right, I gotta take out her battery. Why don't you go... Oh, come on, the battery isn't that heavy, is it? Oh, you could do it! Eh, good enough.
Attacks in one day. I'm breaking records.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
Well, did you find out anything?
Yes.
Did you find your number?
My number? Oh, no, not yet. But I did learn what the children were treated for. Remember I told you that the shape of objects was important to them?
I do.
Well, their illness was called morphophobia, fear of a shape, or to be more precise, an aversion to it.
What kind of shape?
The human body. They couldn't stand the sight of a human body. That was their disease.
What do you mean that they couldn't stand it?
They would literally get sick, vomiting at the sight of any person. Their teachers, doctors, passers-by, their own parents. Even seeing each other in the mirror.
What? I guess that's why anybody was... I guess that's why everybody was forbidden to talk to them. But still... How are they even at the airport? There's people at an airport, I mean... I imagine they must have... worn, like... you know, coverings over their head to prevent them from seeing anybody, otherwise wouldn't they get horribly sick? Getting on an airplane, being on an airplane, getting off an airplane, walking around. You can't avoid seeing humans. And if they couldn't even see each other in the mirror, doesn't that mean they couldn't transfer?
What did they dislike so much about the human body?
We never did find the answer. The children weren't able to articulate their feelings, First of all, they were really young. And secondly, they were unable to communicate at all with anyone. Any attempt at communication caused suffering and psychogenic vomiting.
What an unusual disease.
Yes, which is why the treatment was likewise unusual. Now I know the purpose behind those strange activities. Playing with cubes, collecting parts, and so on.
So why were they assembling an embody on stage?
To cultivate in the children a positive association with the sight of a human body. They were using those bits to independently assemble a fairy tale character, a positive character. And thanks to their efforts, a young woman would take the stage, the defender of beauty, protecting a blossoming garden from a wicked witch.
The witch symbolized ugliness?
Evidently. Beauty would triumph over ugliness, and the children rejoiced at their involvement in bringing about a happy end. Bit by bit, their repulsion toward the human body was thus dislodged from their psyches, replaced by a new mindset which filled the human body with beauty and goodness.
But why did they need to go through a transfer?
The transfer anchored this mindset. All the emotional experience obtained at the Gribera Garden would anchor only in a new body. Otherwise, the therapy had no effect.
I see. And the cubes? What was their purpose?
The cubes have an extremely simple shape. Playing in the pavilions blunted the kids' excessive sensitivity. Their psyches were being simplified so as to start sewing in them trivial categories. Good and evil, beauty and ugliness. Because their perception developed in an anomalous manner, the kids saw the world of shapes very differently, in a way that grown-ups could never understand. And there was no other way to save their lives other than to make them simpler.
I'm still having trouble understanding.
Hold on. Meyer. Inhibish. My name is Ida Meyer.
You remembered?
I found a journal. It contains my data. Here. Ida Meyer, age 26, city of Geneva. My personal number. And a date. August 15th, 2058. What year is it, by the way?
76.
Whoa. So, I'm a psychologist from Geneva, and I've been lying in Mongolian soil for 18 years.
In a candy box. And not in soil, but in sand.
Very well, in sand. And now I'm in a flower vase, trying to verify my number. Only, damn it.
What?
It's not working. The network interface, I can't get online.
I guess the vase doesn't integrate with the web.
Inhibish, there's another network terminal, underneath the TV. It's functional, only without power. If you can power it up, I'll be able to get online.
Okay, so I think here is where I need to do the whole solar panel and batteries thing.
Help me understand something.
What?
How did the kids react to seeing a mechanical body?
The same way as an organic one. They puked.
But then how did they interact with the staff?
Their bouts of morphophobia were suppressed. The complex was equipped with these emitters. I don't know how they worked, but exposure to them enabled the kids to communicate. With the staff, as well as among themselves.
That is very, very vague.
Got it.
Did you power up the terminal?
Not yet.
Yep, put the batteries in the box under the awning. Now's the time for the batteries. Okay, well, I think this is a pretty good place to end the episode, because I just hit a save point. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and in the next episode, I'm going to get the power up and going, and then I think I'm going to finally read all these notes on the floor. So, thank you for watching, and I'll be back soon.